Hey, it's Etan. I'm here in front of the world-famous Rose Bowl in Pasadena. Tens of thousands of screaming college football fans are going to be in those bleachers to watch the Alabama Crimson Tide and the Michigan Wolverines go toe-to-toe in the semifinals. A big game on New Year's Day, or January 2nd, if New Year's happens to be on a Sunday, is a Rose Bowl tradition stretching back to January 1st, 1923, just a couple months after the Rose Bowl opened. I'm about to take a tour of the inside of the Rose Bowl. Come along with me. Full disclosure, sports are not my thing, but I do care a lot about how old buildings evolve, and the Rose Bowl as a structure has a fascinating history. The stadium was completed in 1922 as the home for the East-West Tournament, an annual college football game that was played after the Pasadena Rose Parade each new year. The game was first held in 1902, but it was such a poorly organized, lopsided matchup that they replaced it with chariot and ostrich races. By 1916, college football was gaining in popularity, so they reinstated the game at a field near Caltech for 7 years. Attendance was so high, the Tournament of Roses Association realized the game needed a stadium of its own. Architect Myron Hunt convinced the association to build it in a wide-open part of the Arroyo Seco riverbed. It was a city dump at the time, but a spacious city dump. The elliptical shape of the Rose Bowl was inspired by Roman and Greek coliseums, while its seating arrangement was borrowed from the Yale Bowl. Originally, the stadium was open on the south end to allow for a running track. At the first official Rose Bowl game in 1923, the capacity was 57,000. Hunt had to scale down some of his more elaborate plans to meet the budget, and you can still see the effects of those decisions in the Rose Bowl's Spartan design. But the stadium has undergone a whole slew of updates over the years. The south end was enclosed in the late 20s, and more risers were added over the years. In 1972, you could cram in 105,000 fans. Right now, it's about 92,000 to 93,000. Huge concrete pillars were added to support the upper tiers in the late 40s, the same time the big neon sign went up. Press boxes were added in the 60s and expanded in the 90s. Wooden benches became aluminum, they added bigger screens and better lighting, the field was widened to accommodate the World Cup in 1994. These changes haven't always come easy. This is a National Historic Landmark, and every decision about upgrades is weighed against the need to preserve as many of the character-defining features of the building as possible. Several times in its history, major changes to the structure were strongly opposed by the National Park Service. While the tension between growth and tradition has followed the Rose Bowl throughout its history, the past is ever present here in statues, plaques, and a great little museum housed in one of the original locker rooms. It's behind a door in one of the tunnels that the teams run down for their big entrance on game day. They've preserved the original wood planks that line those tunnels for decades, covering them in a thin layer of concrete so you can still see the wood grain. I love that idea that every player runs by this material echo of the Rose Bowl's earliest days on their way out to the open field. So there you have it. Over a century after it was built, the Rose Bowl continues to blossom. From one Rosenblum to another, I salute you, the Rose Bowl. Happy New Year, and thanks for doing LA with me. Oh, and go blue, roll tide, roll, whatever.